نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم ولا نساء من نساء عسى أن يكن خيرا منهم ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ. Dear brothers and sisters, the verses which I recited right now are the verses from Surah Al-Hujurat. It is chapter number 49 from the Holy Quran. In this surah, first of all, Allah talked about the rights of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. The Muslims are commanded in the beginning of the surah that, O you who believe, do not raise your voice in the gathering of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. In the respect of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, you have to lower your volume. And after a few verses, in this ruku, in the second part of the surah, Allah talked about the rights of fellow Muslims. Obviously, if a person loves Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, he has to love the Ummah of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Because Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, loved each and every of his Ummah, each and every member of his Ummah. So similarly, Muslims should also love and respect the other fellow Muslims. So these are the rights given to the Muslims. And Muslims are underestimating many of the things which are very important in their lives. So we will discuss two verses from Surah Hujurat, verse number 11 and verse number 12. In the beginning of the surah, Allah is saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٌ مِّنْ قَوْمٍ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ. O you who believe, a group from you should not make fun of the other people. Why? عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ. Perhaps that the other people are better than you. You are making fun of them, but it's possible that the people you are making fun of are better than you. The word which Allah has used in this verse is sukhriya. La yaskhar qawmun min qawmin. The word sukhriya means that to look at someone down, to insult someone. And it is done in many ways. Sometimes we do it in the words. The people make fun of the other people in the words. Like they use bad words for them. And when they talk to them and they get to know that this person is not financially strong, so they look down towards that person and they don't talk to that person after that. And it happens that sometimes the people laugh at the appearance of a person. For example, Muslims are sitting in a gathering and a person appears, and because he is a poor person or his appearance is not good, so they smile, looking towards each other, they smile at that person and they are making fun of that person in that way. And it is very common thing that the people are very status conscious. They are sitting in a restaurant and some other family comes and they sit next to them and they are looking very poor. And so the people start looking towards each other and they smile. So you are making fun of the other people and you are considering them lower than you in financial status or in something else. That is known as sukhriya, and it is not allowed to make fun of other Muslims in any way. Why? Because the criteria which Islam gives to the Muslim is that the best amongst you is one who is best in piety. The verses coming in the surah, in verse number 13, Allah has said, Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. That the most honorable amongst you is one who is more pious. And piety is related with our heart. Who is more pious, no one can tell you. It is not necessary that if a person is a scholar and he is delivering the lecture or he has a lot of knowledge, he is more pious than other person. How much piety is there in our hearts? Only Allah knows it. It's possible that there is a person who has a very less amount of knowledge and he is very poor, but he is more pious. He has more fear of God in his heart than other people, even than scholars. That's possible. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, there is a hadith, Rubba Asha'asa Aghbar. There are people who are looking very poor. Their even hair are scattered and their hair are full of dust. Zee Timrain, and there are only two cloth sheets on their body. And Yuswahun Abwabin Nas, and they are thrown away from the gates of the people. The people don't want to talk to them. They are rejected and neglected by the people. لَوْ أَقْسَمَ بِاللَّهِ But they are so close to Allah that if they will take an oath in the name of Allah, لَأَبَرَّهُ Allah will definitely do that whatever they have asked Allah to do. They are so close to God. So through the appearance, we cannot judge the piety of any person. And this is the basic thing which Islam wants to teach. This is the most important teaching, that consider all the people equal and give respect to other people. What was the problem when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, started preaching in Makkah? We know that when the Prophet, peace be upon him, started preaching in Makkah, that one of the greatest problem he was facing was the class consciousness. The people who belonged to the elite class, who were very rich, they asked Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, that how can we sit with you in your gathering? Don't you see the people sitting with you are so poor? Like Bilal is a slave and Abdullah bin Masood is a shepherd, Khabbab ibn Arat is a blacksmith. Sitting with them in your gathering is our insult. So that's why, and this is the basic teaching of Islam, that if you want to sit with the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, we have to accept this equality, because in Islam there is no superiority for anyone other than piety. So that is called Sukhriya. So the Holy Quran said that a group must not make fun of the other group. Look, it starts from individuals. One person makes the fun of the other person. Then it comes into groups. There are political parties with us. They always make fun of each other. They always blame each other. They want to degrade each other. So this thing, making fun of others, increases in the community so much that the people get divided into groups. And it leads towards bloodshed. That's why from the first step, the Holy Quran is saying that one Muslim is not allowed to make fun of the other Muslim. He has no right to do that. But he has to give respect to others as he wants to be respected by the other people. And then Allah also said, وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّن نِسَاءٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُنَّ خَيْرٌ مِّنْهُمْ And some of the women must not make fun of the other women. Allah has mentioned the women separately over here, though it was also included in the Qawm. And the word Qawm is common. Women, men, both were included in that word, but Allah separately mentioned Nisa, because some Mufassirin say that the ways in which women make fun of each other is different from the ways men. Men look towards other person's financial strength. If a person is poor, they will not give respect to that person. But in women, there are other things in which they make fun of each other, like in terms of beauty or in terms of garments or in terms of the lifestyles, they make fun of each other. So that's why Allah has mentioned it separately, وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّن نِسَاءٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُنَّ خَيْرٌ مِّنْهُنْ Women should also avoid making fun of the other women. May the other women, the other group is better than you. The second thing which Allah has mentioned in this verse is وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ Lumps means to find fault in other people. To find faults in other people. وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ Literally it means that don't find faults in yourself. No one finds fault in ourselves. This is the disease in us, that we find faults in other people, but we don't look towards the faults in ourselves. So why Allah is saying over here, وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ Don't find faults in yourself. Because when you will find fault in the other people, and when you will mention them in front of them, so what will be the result of it? They will start finding faults in yourself. So when they will find fault in yourself, so who was the reason behind it? Yourself, because you started it. You found faults in the other people, in return they did it. So that's why Allah said, وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ Don't find faults in yourself. Like in another place in the Holy Quran, Allah said, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ Don't kill yourself. No one kills himself. But if you will start killing some group of people, obviously in the result, that group will start killing your people. So that thing is mentioned in the Quran, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ Don't kill yourself. Similarly, in the Holy Quran, there is a verse in which Allah said, وَلَا تَصُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدُعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَصُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ Don't abuse the gods of the disbelievers. Otherwise, in retaliation, what they will do? They will abuse Allah because of their ignorance. This is the nature of human beings, that if you will accuse someone, if you will blame someone, so in return that person will also start doing the same thing with you. So that's why وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ Don't find faults in the other people. It is done in different ways. Sometimes it happens in the words like you are saying that to another person, that why you are so short? And sometimes you are finding fault in the other person that though you are very intelligent, but why you are so ugly? Why? and why you have this problem and that problem. So they find faults and they make fun of the other people in front of them. In this verse which we are discussing, the three things are forbidden and all these three things are done in front of them. Sukhriya, making fun of others, it is in front of those people. Similarly, the word talmizu means to find faults and mentioning those faults in front of that person, that you have that weakness in yourself. So obviously it is, you are disheartening that person, you are breaking the heart of that person, you are insulting that person, so that is not allowed. Basically, this verse was revealed on the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, after an event. There was a companion of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. His name was Thabit bin Qais, and he had hearing problem. And he used to sit next to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and the companions who knew about it, they used to give him the space. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, also asked the Sahaba that when he comes, you should give him the space near me. But once there was a Jummah prayer and all the people were sitting, obviously, and so Thabit bin Qais came and he wanted to go near the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and he was climbing the shoulders of the Prophet. So one person did not know about him. So he got angry with him that why you are going, there is no space. So who are you? So Thabit bin Qais mentioned his name, Thabit bin Qais bin Shammas. And you know that Arabs are very expert in the genealogical tables. So he said, okay, you are the son of that lady. The reputation of Thabit bin Qais' mother in the time of ignorance was not good. So he insulted him by naming his mother in front of all the people. Okay, you are the son of that person. So it is, the verses are revealed that don't look down at someone because of the previous lives. It is also common in our society that your father, you are the same person whose father was arrested last week, and it was here in the news channel that he did that much corruption. And you are making fun of someone, okay, you are the son of that person who is a peon, who is working as a clerk in that office. So it is very common in our society that the people make fun of each other and they look down to other people, all these things. And these are the sins which are so common in our society. We underestimate them, but Allah dislikes them a lot. And one more thing which Allah has mentioned in this verse, وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. This is the third thing which Allah has mentioned, وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. That don't call each other with your nicknames. Alqab, laqab is that thing which shows the quality of some person. Sometimes the alqab are very good. Like Hazrat Abu Bakr is given the title of As-Siddiq by Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And Hazrat Umar was called Farooq. These are very good titles. They show the good qualities and those personalities. But sometimes the people give the nicknames to other people just to make fun of them. And it is very common in our classrooms. We see that the students have different names. They don't call that person with his actual name, which his parents gave, but they call him with a different name. Like there was a class, I saw that the people call a child Panda. Oh, everybody is calling him Panda. And there was a class in which every child had a different name. And the same thing was there in Medina, Banu Salama. It is said in the background of this verse, it is said that when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, came to Medina, there was a tribe, Banu Salama, and in that tribe, every person had two or three names. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, called someone with a name. So Sahaba informed Holy Prophet, Ya Rasulullah, that he dislikes this name of him. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, why do you call him with this name? He did not know about it, that the people tease him with this name. So at that time, this verse was revealed, وَنَا تَرَى بَسُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. Don't call each other with nicknames, but you should call him with the name which the parents have given to him. And there is another thing which we need to notice over here. وَلَا تَلْمِسُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. There is a, it is something related to the Arabic language, that there is a بَابِ مُفَعَلَى. It is تَلْمِسُوا. And over there, وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا. Allah didn't say تَنْبِزُوا, but Allah said تَنَابَزُوا. تَنَابَزُوا means that don't call each other with their nicknames. But over here, Allah said وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا. Because when someone finds a fault in yourself and mentions it in front of you, you cannot return it at that time because you don't know about the faults of that person. But if you will call another person with some name, it is very easy. You can give any name to that person. Then and there, you can take the revenge. So that's why Allah has used the word tanabazu, that don't start calling each other with the nicknames, but give respect to each other. So these are the things forbidden in this ayah. And then Allah said, بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ. How bad it is to get the name of fasiq after your iman. بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ. You people are believers. You got the name of mu'min. So how bad it is to be called fasiq, because all these things which are mentioned in this ayah makes you fasiq. If a person is making fun of another person, if a person is abusing another person, if a person is making fun of another person through his nickname, so these are the things which Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said a believer cannot do, but these are the signs of a fasiq. So how bad it is that you were mu'min and then you got the title of fasiq. Whenever in the Holy Quran, Allah starts some words with Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe, it means that the things which are coming in that verse are the requirements as a believer. If you are really a believer, you have to do that. And if you will not do that, so obviously you will be out of Islam and you will not be called a true believer at least. And then Allah said, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ, and whoever will not do tawbah, so they are the wrongdoers. Sometimes we don't remember the things. Sometimes we forget the things because it is a common thing that we don't recite the Holy Quran so repeatedly and regularly. So we forget the teachings of the Holy Quran. Many a times we don't even realize that it is a sin in Islam. But after knowing all of it, but after having the knowledge of the Quran and the guidance of Islam, even then, if a person will not change his lifestyle, if a person will not change his language, if a person will not be worried about his words, his talking about, so obviously they are wrongdoers, they are ignoring and they are underestimating the commands of Allah. So in this verse, verse number 11 of Surah Hujurat, Allah has mentioned the three things which we do in front of the people to hurt them. In the next verse, verse number 12, Allah has mentioned and Allah has forbidden three other things which we do in the absence of the people, but they are also forbidden and they are also haram in Islam. The first thing is that the Holy Quran says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu jitanibu kathiran min al-dhan. O you who believe, avoid suspicion. Avoid suspicion. Avoid making assumptions about other people. Inna ba'da dhanni ism. Indeed, some of the assumptions are sin. What is assumption? What is suspicion? That you have no idea. You don't have any strong evidence about some person, about something, and you are assuming something wrong about that person. And it is also a very common thing. For example, if a person is watching something in his mobile, and when you get closer to that person, he switches off his screen. Now you are assuming he must be looking something indecent. That's why when I came, he suddenly shuts his mobile screen. You don't know what he was looking in the mobile, but you assumed something wrong. It's sin. That's why you are considering another person wrong. Similarly, the people make assumptions. For example, if I am going to the mosque and I saw that another person is going in front of the mosque, but he is not coming to join the salah. So I will start thinking that how bad this person is, it's fasiq. He knows that the prayer is going on and he is not coming to the mosque. I will consider him a bad Muslim. But I should know, I don't know, maybe he was in some kind of emergency which allows him to leave the congregation at the time and to fulfill that thing. It's possible. So whenever we see someone, so we should take a positive thing about him. We should interpret him in a positive way. If someone is saying something about you, so you should not take it negatively in the first attempt, but you should try to find out some possible positive interpretation about that person. There is a recent case that I was in. There is a person who was sick, so he did not inform anyone about his sickness because he thought that if my enemies or my competitors or my opposition will get to know about my sickness, they will be very happy. How you can say that they will be very happy? Why you are thinking so negatively about the people that when they will get to know about my sickness or about my loss, they will be very happy? So think positive things about the other people and don't assume that they are so bad. It is something haram. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said that inna dhanna akzabul hadith. The biggest lie is assumption. You have no proof, you have no evidence, and you have some thing in your mind about the other person, a negative thing. So that is a sin we must avoid, and we should always have good thoughts about the other people. If we find them doing something or saying something, we should try to find out the positive interpretation. Until and unless we actually know or we saw something with our own eyes, we must not have any bad thoughts about another person. The next thing which Allah has forbidden us from is wala tajassasu, and don't spy. Tajassus means to find out the things about other person for no reason. Why the people want to, they do spying, and why they want to find out the things from the other people? Because of their own benefits. For example, you know that it is very common thing in our media, in our newspapers, that they look for some kind of fault in celebrities, in politicians, in famous people, and they found something, some weakness in them. Every person has faults in it, every person has weaknesses in it, but you are looking for that fault so that you will do marketing of it and you will print it in your newspaper and you will make money for that. So how bad it is that you are making, you are disclosing the weaknesses of the other people just for your own benefit. Or you are doing spying, but just because, for example, in a classroom it is possible that a child wants that this person is getting a lot of respect and importance in the classroom. I should find something which will degrade him in the eyes of the other person. You are doing spying so that you will inform. It happens in the offices also, that someone wants another person not to be so important in the office, so they try to find out some weakness about that person to get the benefit of it, to inform their authorities, the upper authorities about it, to get the benefit. It is such a bad thing. So the Holy Quran says, "Wala tajassasu," don't spy. There is another word in Arabic that is tahassasu. Sometimes both the words are used in the same meaning. There is a hadith in which Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Wala tajassasu, wala tahassasu." But some of the scholars say that tajassasu means to do the spying, to find out something negative, something bad, and tahassasu is used to find out something good. Like in Surah Yusuf, there is a verse in which Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salam said to his sons, "Ya bani yadhhabu wa tahassasu," oh my children, go to Egypt and try to find out Yusuf and his brother from there. So that tahassasu is to find out something good. So tajassus is also wrong, but in some cases tajassus is allowed. What that case could be, the officer can have, you know that in offices there are cameras everywhere, what the officials are doing, that is allowed, because they have to check that they are doing their job perfectly or not, they are wasting their time. Similarly, the government is having the cameras everywhere. They have to check that what is going on in the town. But as an individual, we must not do that kind of spying for another person. That is not allowed. That is something haram. And then the third thing which Allah has mentioned over here in this verse is that saram wala yaqtab ba'dukum ba'da, and some of you must not backbite the other people. Backbiting is that if a person has a fault, a person has a weakness, and you are telling that weakness and that fault of that person to other people in his absence, that is known as ghibah. The companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, ask him that, "Ya Rasulullah, if that bad quality is really present in that person, then," Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "that is riba. And if he will say something which is not there in that person, that will be called slandering. That is called buhtan. That is a bigger sin than riba as well." And there is another thing in between, that you are not confirmed about that bad quality of that person, but still you are telling it to the other people, that is known as ifk. That is known as ifk. So there are three things. Ghibat is that a person has a bad quality in him and you know about it and you are telling that thing to other people, that is ghibah. The second thing is that you don't know, you are not confirmed about that bad quality of that person. You just heard it from someone and you quoted it to the other person, that is called ifk. And that is a bigger sin than ghibah. And the third thing is buhtan. You know that this quality is not there in that person, but still you are telling the other person that he has this quality, that is the bigger sin, that is called buhtan. If you know, the word ifk is used for in the Holy Quran in the case of Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. When Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha was accused by the people did not know about that thing. Obviously it didn't happen, they just heard and they talked about Hazrat Aisha's case with Safwan bin Mu'attil. So the Holy Quran has used the word ifk, that is also a sin. And Allah has given an example of ghibah. What ghibah is, أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُهُ. Allah is asking that, does anyone of you like to eat the flesh of his dead brother? فَقَرِهْتُمُ, no, you abhor it. You will never like to eat the flesh of your dead brother. So why Allah is giving this example over here, that backbiting is something similar to eating the flesh of the dead brother. Because look, if a person is dead lying in front of you and you are taking out the flesh from his body and eating it, will that person do anything in his defense? No, because he is dead. So how can he defend himself? Similarly, if a person is not present in his gathering, and you are backbiting that person, he cannot defend himself. If he will be there, so obviously he will be able to defend himself. You are taking the advantage of his absence and you are degrading that person. So it is just like eating the flesh of the dead brother. You can also say that if that dead person will get life, for example, just assume that if that person gets life back, so obviously he will feel a lot of pain if the flesh is taken out from his body. Similarly, when that person will get to know that you are saying this and that about him in his absence, how much pain will he feel for that? So it is the same example Holy Prophet Allah is giving over here, that backbiting someone is just like the eating the flesh of the dead brother. There was a person amongst the companion of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, his name was Ma'is, and he came to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and he accepted that I have committed adultery, so I want to be punished. Within this world I want to be punished, so that when I will go to Allah, I will be purified from this sin. That's a long story, and finally he was stoned. But when they were going back, so two people talked about Hazrat Ma'iz radiallahu ta'ala an, and one of them said to the other person that Allah had covered his sin. No one knew about his sin, but he came to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and he accepted it, and he was stoned like a dog. The people stoned him as the people stone a dog. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, heard this sentence about Ma'iz, and then on the way there was a dead donkey, its body was lying. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, where are the two people? He called them, and Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, eat from this dead donkey. They said, Ya Rasulullah, who can eat it? Holy Prophet said, you have done it a little before. What you said about Ma'iz is worse than eating this dead donkey. It is worse than that. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, there are many other occasions in which Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, identified, we don't care about it. Once a lady came to Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and when she went away, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha did just a gesture. She was short. Only a gesture to inform Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, she was so short. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said that you have said something that if you will put this thing into the sea, it will make it dirty. You have backbited that lady. We have no right to make fun of that person. So these are the small things. You are we don't care about it, and they are sins. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, went to Miraj, and Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was taken to hell by Jibril alayhi salam, and he was shown different type of people who were giving different punishments. So Holy Prophet said, I came across a group of people, they were having the nails of brass and they were scratching their own face, they were scratching their own body. So I asked Jibril, what is the sin of these people? Holy Prophet, we see when I was informed that they are the backbiters. So that's why it's very, very indecent thing that make fun of the weaknesses of other people and sharing it in his absence. And the person who is sitting and enjoying it is also equal in the sin. They are both equal in the sin. That's why whenever we are sitting and we are talking about something, about some person, we need to be very careful that we should not disclose the weaknesses of that person. In some cases, it's allowed. For example, you want to do a job in some office and you are asking another person that you have worked with that person for many years. So what do you suggest? Should I go to that person for work or not? Then because he is asking for a suggestion, so you can say that these are some problems in that person. Like he gets angry very quickly, or he does not give some money on time to his employers. These are the issues in that office. Now it's up to you whether you want to go or not. So he's not doing backbiting because another person is seeking his suggestion, because he has to take a very important decision. Your purpose is not to degrade that person or insult that person in the society, but your purpose is just to guide your brother so that he can make a correct decision. For example, if a person wants to marry in a particular family. So obviously they have to get the information from the other people, and the other people should not only praise that person, but they should tell the reality that if there are weaknesses or faults in that person, they should inform, because they are going to take some very important decision. So in that case, that will not be counted as a ghiba. Similarly, in Ilmul Hadith, there is a, you know, there is a branch of knowledge in Hadith that is called Asma'ur Rijal. In Asma'ur Rijal, Muhaddith out. So these are the things which Allah has asked us to avoid. And finally Allah said, Wattaqullah, all these things will become easy for you only when you will have taqwa. Wattaqullah, fear Allah. If a person will develop the fear of Allah, fear of Allah, what does it mean? The God consciousness. If a person is always having this feeling in his mind that Allah is watching me, Allah is with me, I have to go back to Allah and I have to take the rewards from Allah and Allah can punish me on my things. If all the time you have this thing in yourself, that is called taqwa, that is called the God consciousness. And only this feeling makes a person muttaqi or pious. When we forget Allah, we commit sin. But when we remember Allah in our mind, all the things become easy for us. So that's why we should develop taqwa. Inna Allah tawwabur rahim. And in the end, Allah said, Allah is tawwab and Allah is rahim. Tawwab means Allah accepts tawbah. Now you are realizing that after reading these verses, after understanding these verses, that it was very common in my life. I used to make fun of my siblings. I used to make fun of my cousins. I did backbite of that person, these things. But Allah is Tawwab. If you will do Tawbah, Allah will definitely accept the Tawbah. And Ar-Rahim, Allah's quality is Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, that Allah is very kind and merciful. A person can get tired of committing sins, but Allah will never get tired of forgiving the people. Allah loves those people who come back to Allah and seek His forgiveness. May Allah give us understanding of the Quranic verses, and may Allah make us a good Muslim, a good human, and may Allah give us the strength to give rights to all the fellow Muslims. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alamin.